Happy Saturday, everyone. I bet you weren't expecting this one unless you watched the Facebook page for HPI Guys Workshop, because I did a little preview of this on there. But this just rolled in off the big brown UPS truck, and we're going to build it up today. I had shown some pictures on the Facebook page how excited I was to see this out. It is the 1965 Chevy Chevelle El Camino by AMT with camper top. In 1/25th scale, it is a 3-in-1 kit. You can build it stock, custom, or race and drag version, in other words, what I would call it. Filled with all kinds of stuff. When you open this box, it is right up to the top. They give you some cool paint and decoration ideas on the box there. So let's start opening up all the plastic and see what we've got going on in the workshop today. We will start out with the dashboard. We got some nice molding in there, got a little radio in there, glove box, we've got our wheel backs for the custom wide wheels, we've got a stock steering wheel which is molded nice and open, not seeing any flash on there, got a little tree with some wheel backs as well, we got lots of custom parts in here, we've got our small block, we've got our drag racing front suspension, I'm guessing that's to raise the front end a little bit. Cylinder heads, valve covers, dual carburetors if you want to go that route. We've even got a six-pack of beverages and two hard hats. We've got some custom body materials. We've got our oil pan with starter and oil filter because it's an engine where the axle will go right through the block. Air cleaner on there, distributor, water pump, belt and pulley housing. So it's got everything there to make a nice-looking representation of the powers. The powertrain, got our firewall with a surprising amount of detail on it, even a blower motor, got our radiator, some license plates on there, got our stock seats, which look pretty comfy, got our hood, go underneath, it is cut out if you want to bring the motor up above the hood, you just have to start scribing across, otherwise it's got great detail, a hood latch, supports and everything on there. Really nice. Let's start looking at some other stuff here. What do we got on the table? We've got some custom racing seats. You want to really customize this thing out. On this tree here, we've got some wheel backs. We've got some custom steering wheel. And we got a side of the camper. That is just awesome. We're definitely building the camper in this video. You would know that by the thumbnail, but there's great detail on that. This is the roof, all that corrugated steel. Even got the vent in there. You can look on the box art for detailing ideas for that camper or do it yourself. Got our marker lights on there. Window cutouts, another more vents on there. That's so cool looking. We're going to enjoy this one. Got our rear door. It does go like this. It does have a little awning over the door. Got our little aluminum door, license plate frame molded in, marker lights on the back. Then we've got our overhead. This goes over the cab. Even though you can't really see that, it's still corrugated. Looks awesome. Little window on the top. There is no interior provided for the camper in this kit. Got our interior tub. Large mounts. Let us know it's going to be easy to mount in there. For being a one-piece stamping, they still got some great detail on the door panels, even though they're pretty plain in this El Camino. The chassis is a one-piece affair. Outer frame rails, exhaust is molded in, differentials molded in, front suspension's molded in, and then you would stack that drag suspension over the top to give you that nose high look of the day. But it is nice looking. It is a nice looking compliment on there. And then we've got the El Camino body, which is a one piece affair with the included bed built in. Got our tailgate, got our taillight mounting. Should be quite easy to work on. Even got our rear bumper mount. All of our trim is nice and prominent. So we can use our markers to get in there. Door handles. Careful of those vent windows. Don't want to break those off. Windshield wipers are molded in, but they are very crisp. Bed looks great, and it looks deep enough. It doesn't look super shallow like it's fake. So the body looks awesome. That's all the white styrene. On the other side of the table, we've got the nice new decal sheet. Yes, it does have gauges, even has the large gauge in there. Got a radio, all the Chevy emblems we will need, including the scripting, the El Camino scripts, the logos. We've got 65 license plates. We got California plates on there. We've got some really cool, I always like these, Happy's Camping Grounds, driver Chuck Miller, Nationals or Bust Downriver Automotive with the camper on it. You can make this a drag Camino. 327 under the hood. This is a red and white stripe. It's not two separate red stripes, though you could make it that way. It is one large red with white down the center stripe and a white border. Chevrolet logo for the hood, and it's not individual letters. I really like that. Nice looking decal sheet for this kit coming back out. We've got two clear parts trees, custom grill. We've got the parts for the windows in the camper. And just so you know, the frames on these are very prominent. So we will be able to do our aluminum trim like they would have done on the real thing before we install them. That's nice to have. We've got some headlight glass in there, some side light glass for the overhead sleeper on the camper. Then we've got the stock El Camino back and front glass as one piece, which makes installation super easy. And our headlights, transparent red, tail lights, and custom lights make our jobs easier as well. Always like that stuff. Two steel axles based on the promo style chassis. We knew it would have steel axles. We've got one. We've got two entire chrome trees. This one is the blower. Small gauge package, it looks like there, or the rail for the blower. Sorry, that's for something else. So that's a nice chrome tree right there. Got our stock grill with bumper built in. That will accept a black wash nicely. It's very shallow. Stock wheels, custom wheels, manifolds, headers, exhaust dumps, custom grill, stock rear bumper, custom valve covers, custom intakes, all kinds of goodies. And that's not it in this box. You know those tire sets that they sell online from AMT and all that? They're like 20 bucks a set, 15 bucks. Well, check this out in this ride. We've got a beautiful set of bias ply white walls with gold Firestone lettering on the other side. So you can decide how you want to build those up. Great tread pattern. We've seen those. Those are solid. We got a set of MH Race Masters. For those of you who want to drag race this bad boy, drag Camino would look really awesome. And an entire set of their exquisite Firestone wide oval tires. Hollow tires, wide tread, black wall on the other side. So you can go stock. You can go stock-ish like I like to do. You can do anything you want with this bad boy. You've got so many options in this box. So many parts will be left over no matter how you build it, from headers to manifolds to whatever you want. So we've got lots of options in here. You know how I like to build my stuff. I like the looks I like. So I'm going to start gluing my version together, and we'll be right back. Color me surprised, but I thought this camper would be way harder to assemble than it was. I guess I'm just thinking of the larger semi-trailers with so many parts and trying to hold things square. If you build it with the roof on the table, it puts itself together. As you saw, it goes together so, so nicely. Really happy. And the bottom is wide open, obviously, to get into the box so that they could put all their camping stuff and, you know, do their thing in it. So that means we'll be able to get in from the inside to install our glass, because you do need to install the glass from the inside. So we'll be able to get in there and do that. We'll be able to do our window frames on there. This is a really, really nice camper for the back of that El Camino. I haven't seen if it will fit any other vehicles, but yeah, and it squares itself up. Look, we're not looking at any big gaps, any big issues. Well, there is a gap along here, but that's more my fault. I got to work on squeezing that in and holding that together. But yeah, the body lines, the back ridge, the sides, they all just have grooves that they fit into. And you saw me running beads of glue in there, and it holds tight. I mean, it's a really nice assembly. I like that. The body didn't need much work at all. Just glued the firewall in place. So, and then made sure that the interior would fit. I don't want to do that at the end because I'm always afraid of getting glue on the body and stuff. So I always like to do that, and then I can easily reach in there and paint that firewall. 327 is all set to go. A lot of you, of course, won't like this engine because it's got that groove for the metal axle. Doesn't bother me. Once my kits are assembled, I'm not flipping them over and turning them around. The stock exhaust manifolds, the stock intake, and oil filler are done on the chrome tree. So you saw I sanded the intake down to get it to fit on with model glue, then use super glue to attach the distributor, carburetor, oil filler, and the manifolds. We'll get that all painted up. We'll get rid of that chrome. We'll make it look like a more stock 327. Got the beer cans, the beverage cans, and the hard hats. Definitely going to put those in the cab. Got our seats. We're not going to be using these wheelbacks. Got our belt and pulley system glued together. The kit assembles super, super, super easy. Once you're done with the camper, you're not going to have problems with anything. This hole in here, we don't have to worry too much about. It will be hidden when we're in here, and this is so that the center console and all its metallic glory can push up in the middle. See how nice that's going to look? Don't have to decorate that or nothing. Just have to blackwash that console and push it in once we do our interior color. So, folks, that's it. Super short sub-assembly show-off. The chassis needs no work because I'm not doing the drag version. If you did, you'd be gluing this suspension in, and then you'd be done with it. So that would fit right over the top to duplex it up so that you can install your axle at a lower height and make her stand up like that. So that's pretty interesting. And then these wheelbacks will be used with the wider tires and the custom wheels. And if you want to do the drag tires, you need the wider backs on those custom wheels. These wheelbacks, the shallow ones, are for our stock hubcaps. That's what those would be used for. So we've got all these extra parts on here that I'm not going to be using on that grill. We'll put our headlights in with some future floor polish and let them dry so that they look awesome on there. I'm going to take all this stuff over, decide my paint colors, and start doing it right now.
Thank you.
at this point in this thoroughly enjoyable build, let's take a look at the bare bones of the painted and completed final assemblies before I put the kit together. Now, I'm not anticipating any issues. I didn't have any issues the last time I built the 65 El Camino with getting the chassis inside the body. It tends to just kind of snap up in there, like the promo style that it is. I've got the rear bumper ready. I did the taillights in that white pen. You can get those anywhere. Any craft store will have a white flat marker. We've got the interior done. Had to use that six pack, painted it blue like a six pack of Pepsi. We got both our hard hats, one on the seat, one spare on the floor. We've got the dashboard done. I did do the aluminum style inlay in the dashboard with the dash gauges and the radio, and that looks pretty awesome to me. Stock shifter, that console pushing up from the bottom is just beautiful. Makes that so easy. Black wash the lower portions and it looks awesome. And then hand painted that steering wheel. Did a black on black. Used that silver pen that I have, that gel pen, to do like the door handles and the window cranks on that black interior. And it looks great. It looks every bit the part. We have some small stuff to attach once we're done, like the air cleaner and the radiator hose. We'll look at the chassis. Didn't do any weathering or anything on the chassis. Pretty simple with this one, just painted it up, installed the 327, and that's all set to go. Just basic paint and detail on that. The wide oval with the mags look awesome. They just look great. They look tough. They look, I mean, just, yeah, and they're hollow all the way through. Something about that black, or that matte clear coating of an enamel from Rustoleum, with the enamel black wash, which is what the Tamiya is, it's an enamel, brings down that chrome shine. You still get a lot of shine, but it brings it down to a more scale, real world level. And I don't know why it does that. It's just a chemical reaction that we found out that works, and it's really cool. The camper, I wanted to complement that bronze body style, so I did a black stripe down the side. All aluminum trim, got all of our vents done, our marker lights, our taillight reflectors, got our door trim. On the box art, they have the door in a separate color, but my grandpa had a camper just like this on his 83 Chevy, right? 83, 85, I don't know. It was a square body, long box Chevy four-wheel drive. His had the black stripe. There wasn't any colored doors on it. It was all the yellow painted steel or aluminum, whatever it was made out of. It was all white. So I left it like that. I like that look better, the plain Jane steel. Did the aluminum trim around the windows. We'll put a license plate on there when we're done. Got our vents and everything all set up on this. So it's a really cool looking piece of work. Got our front marker lights, got our front window. I mean, it's really awesome, and it just sits right up there so you can display your El Camino any way you want, with the camper or without it. And I think the black stripe complements it. If they would have had some black hood stripes, that would have looked even more BA. Got our trim done on this one. I just decided to use the silver Sharpie around the trim and all that, and then painted it in. Door handles, doesn't stand out a lot on that bronze, but it does look good. Got our taillights in. Taillights are just held in with Molotow or a Mod Podge. Got our firewall, I hand painted that with some Tamiya semi-gloss black. Got our radiator glued in place, got our reservoir tank and our battery glued in place. And then we've got the grill just pressed in. I'll remove that at any time, but it's a nice friction fit. Did some Tamiya clear orange. You saw how I black washed the grill and stuck the headlights in place. So that is it. I just have to press everything together, hang the rear bumper like so, press all the body parts together, press the interior in, and then the chassis will mount. The interior mounts there, the chassis will mount in those pins back there and press in tight. Not having any problems, don't anticipate any, but if I do, I'll let you know. So on the fits and finishes of everything, only one tiny issue. The mag wheels, which are the first time I've used them on this kit. The steel axles are a little large for the holes in the back of the mag wheels, so I did have to use my little pin vise and some quick speed drill bits. I used a 160, 1.6 millimeter, and I drilled those out and then glued them in place. Otherwise, I tried pressing them into the back of one wheel and it snapped the stud in half. Luckily, it was still enough there to glue on, but I do want you to test fit that if you use the mag wheels. to make sure that they will fit, and if not, gently drill them out and then glue them in place so you don't split a wheel, because once you split that stud off, it gets real hard to put that wheel on properly. I will finish the easy assemblies, then I will put on the El Caminos, the 327s, the Chevy, the tailgate logo, and the grill logo. Let it dry. The paint came out so nice on this that I don't think I'm going to clear coat it at all. Just going to set the decals on it, let it dry, and we'll come back for that final. Another successful build completed of a fun AMT kit from the past, now issued with the custom camper. I think you've seen me build a similar El Camino, if not the same one, as a construction vehicle with a very small topper on it. Now this thing's got the big honking custom camper. It sits right. I wanted to go with the custom wheels just because those Firestone wide ovals are so cool looking, and that would be a very, very common thing to do with these cars, would be to swap out the wheel and tire package on it as they got a little older and a little used. I went with a simple concept on my camper, but instead of painting the back door like they did on the box art, I went and put that stripe on it. We've all seen some of those old topper style campers. They have that decorative stripe on it to look kind of cool. I think it looks awesome. We got clearance lights on this thing. We've got all the little vents and everything for the little stoves it would have had and all that stuff. So this is a fun model to build. It's very easy to build as well. Anyone that can build a model with a little bit of glue can get this kit done. It's not hard at all. You can do it. Even if this is your first model kit ever, you could build this without fighting anything at all. I'm serious, it's that easy to build. You saw me glue stuff together. You saw how easy the camper goes together in this video. Threw that beautiful bronze paint job on it. On this one, we went cheapo paints all the way around. We went with a $3 can of Krylon for the color. I went with Rust-Oleum primer on the topper and the body, and a Rust-Oleum gloss white. A can of that gloss white will last a bajillion cars. That bronze Krylon shortcut, a can of that for some reason lasts even longer than the tester's model paint. You can get quite a few cars out of that too. So I enjoy doing this more subdued, subtle look. If we had some black hood stripes on this thing, like the SS El Camino, that would make this a really cool sports car as well. And you can remove the camper anytime you want if you just want an El Camino. Sell this to your buddies at the model club. Have a good time. Or leave it with the kit. Build it up. Decorate it as you want. Now this kit has those gorgeous decals in it. Really wished I could have used some of them. I was thinking about putting Happy's Camping Grounds, but these will look good on some work trucks, all this stuff, Nationals or Bust. I mean, they're going to look good on anything. We got that nice red stripe in there. We got all these accessories for the dragster, all the drag Camino parts and everything. So don't forget about those, because they are beautiful, beautiful decals. I just decided to actually make this look more real world and all that. But those Happy Campers, I'm still tempted, maybe I will later, to throw those on the door, because they do look good. There wasn't enough room to put them on the camper itself. Otherwise, I would have stuck them on the back of the camper or something like that. That's the kind of place you'd see stuff like that, bumper stickers and whatnot. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this kit over. I will link down in the description where you can get this beautiful machine on pre-order and get it for yourself and start building it up and have a good time. When you get your El Camino camper or any kit, build it the way you want, in the colors you want. Make it look the way you want. Decorate it up and have fun, because that's the whole point of a hobby. This is Chris with HPI Guys Workshop, and I will see all of you at the next review. Thank you.